is way up here.
Okay.
And we don't have to worry about it blocking your cervix.
Oh, that's good.
And over here we see your baby's head.
Yay. I grew up in California, in the Bay Area, and I've known that I wanted to be a doctor since high school. I actually started interning in an OBGYN's office in a low-income, primarily Hispanic neighborhood as a 10th grader. While I was here, I participated in a couple different global health programs. I went to Bolivia our first year of medical school, and so it was a organized rotation and elective during our spring break, and we had 15 students go. And it was an incredible experience to go as a first-year student and kind of work in the different hospitals and clinics, and even just working with the nurses as they did home visits, and seeing a different type of public health system. And then just a couple months ago, I went to Honduras with a family doctor. And at that point, it was, you know, complete change from where we were as first-year medical students, where now we were doing everything from start to finish with our patients, and they really were our patients, that we saw them, we diagnosed them, we managed them, and that was also a great experience. Kind of getting towards the end of first year is when I got involved with health policy and also with some service activities here. So, I guess with health policy, I've been involved with Doctors for America, and that's something that I've continued to do for the last 4 years, and kind of over the last 4 years worked my way from the Maryland State Director to the Northeast Regional Director for the organization, and now I'm getting involved on a national level as well. And so it's been wonderful to be involved with health policy, especially at a time when health reform is happening, and also to be so physically close to DC, where if they call me and say, hey, tomorrow, this actually happened, that I got a phone call on Tuesday night saying Senator Feinstein wants somebody from Doctors for America to stand on stage with her. And the very next morning, I could jump on the MARC train and get down to DC and was on stage with Senator Feinstein at her press conference. And that's happened more than once. And I think being physically close to DC is a big factor in that. We've made a lot of very, very good friends, people who we're gonna be friends with for the rest of our lives. I met my fiance here, as well as a lot of our other classmates who met their significant others here. And I think at the end of the day, it's our classmates that they're the ones who really inspire us to do whatever it is that we're passionate about as well. And I think it's incredible when you hear about some of the things that your classmates have achieved while they're also going through medical school. And every time you hear about some new award or some new project that they've done, it really blows you away and makes you thankful to be here with everyone.